I don't really care about any of the characters in Danmachi, but, like, you know. Yeah, the boob string is quite strong. So we got Earthshaker versus his father, Nixie. Nixie dying at zero, killing himself, because he's a good player. And you know what they say, a stock is not a lead, or that's what Sam would say, most definitely. I don't say that, because I mean, that's how you win the games. You have a stock lead, and then you get the biggest stock lead of having it when they are dead.
Yeah, if they're dead, you win.
Yeah, if they're dead, you win. You're going? Did you lose?
Yeah, I
lost. Wow, you suck.
Yeah,
they're
pretty
bad.
Yeah. How was this matchup? Oh, I see. I've been
getting
a lot of
literally, no, he... It doesn't matter what matchup give him, because he literally got killed himself at zero.
Never came back.
That's a secret nest tag.
So Earthshaker actually taking
you sacrifice a stock to get to do better the next stock.
Yeah, of course. That's just how it
yeah,
works.
Yeah, blood sacrifice, right?
But it didn't actually work because you know there's a percent chance, you know, percent chance pass or fail. But Nixie going staying with Ness, he's like, hey, I literally killed myself that game, so I think I can beat you.
Yep.
Right? Oh, interesting that the jab actually worked, because it looked like it was on the backside of the shield, but as we can see here, Earthshaker's actually getting these juggles pretty well with these up airs, and kind of just subverting what Nick wants to do in neutral pretty well, especially like as we can see with that back throw. Ooh, that was like the longest tomahawk grab I've ever seen. Oh, that back air is not actually going to take it quite yet. Oh wow, but the catch with the up air is going to take it. Earthshaker is trying to slay his father's little boy. He's like, you don't need any other children. I'm the only one in your life. Especially after this set.
If Nixie can just hit this one stock, maybe there's a chance.
Yeah, Nick is probably going to be looking for Ness's well-known kill options of a back throw and up air. Maybe even a back air, very, very potent kill move there as well. Nair not as potent, but it's still a very, very good tool nonetheless.
Keeping her off the ground.
Oh, wow. Ooh, nice. That was literally just frame data right there. Both grabbing. ZSS has a very, has a much longer grab, but also is a lot slower to come out. Alright, keeping Ness off stage is a good idea. Not getting that extension you wanted with that PK fire there. But, that's always so scary when Ness is do that, because you really don't want to somehow wind up on
they have so much control.
Yeah, on the bad side of that thunder. Ooh! Almost taking the stock there. That was a really great DI from Nixie, but it's also a really good connection there from Earthshaker. Yeah, but I wouldn't count Nixie out quite yet. He can easily rack up some percent and kill ZSS pretty early, especially with this small amount of rage he's got going. You know.
Keep her off stage.
That's something I don't want to ever see again after S4C. Chloe actually losing his last stock to a PK fire, just like that on Smashville. But you know he also.
Wait.
Back throw, nice. Taking it.
How do I know?
Is it two or three?
It's two or three.
Alright, we're going to see. Smashville.
Yeah, so game one was kind of a fluke, some might say. But game two was very, very close. It could have gone either way. So just thinking back to Smashville is probably the correct decision to make. Even though this is by far Ness's best stage. But Earthshaker seems very comfortable on it, so why not?
Earthshaker
was ahead in the second round. Yeah, he's been ahead nearly this entire set until he lost.
Yep.
Oh wow, that platform could have made something nasty happen. But I don't think anyone was ready for it. Ooh, but the up air once again taking it since he was so high up in the air.
We're starting to see a repeat of the last two.
Ooh, great scoop up with that grab. Trying to find the juggles. Not letting him land. Ooh, the lasso. We brawl now. Ooh, he did read that roll with the flip kick, but...
Percents are starting to get a little closer.
Yeah, Nixie's really going to have to pull out something right now, and it could be from this edge guard.
That would be a repeat of last time.
Back here? No, not taking it quite yet.
Ooh!
Wow, reverse nair, but still not going to be enough. This is. Earthshaker was just trying to hold on to this stock as much as possible. Oh wow, the beefy up B is I like to call it.
Good use of the ability and flexibility.
Ooh, narrow shield yet. I'm going to take a thesis super high percent. And as we saw from last game, Nixie isn't out of this at all.
There's a good chance that he could be able to a few
jabs. Yeah. Oh wow! The reverse hit! I can't believe
still
it!
In the game.
That's actually plot armor bullshit!
That was crazy.
Ooh. Wow, that's actually kind of bullshit as well. I can't believe Zeus somehow fell out of the thing that's on the ground. How do you fall out of something that's on the ground? Doesn't want to get hit by anything, especially that PK fire. But that flip kick is actually going to take it! Omar is in winner's finals!
Winner's finals, oh baby. That fucking flip kick at the end.
SD Omar.
SD Omar.